So imagine now when we speak to our children who are growing up in a world that may have many different things going on in it than what we experienced. How do we reach them? How do we get them to understand us and we understand them? The first step is by recognizing that each generation will always have a different version of the song that we had when we were growing up. Parents just don't understand. This is part of Sunnat al-Hayah, that as we grow older, we look back at our own parents and we think, wow, we really gave them a run for their money. And our children will get to that point as well. I remember when I was growing up, again, I'm kind of giving away my age here, but back in the 80s, Michael Jackson was very big. And he had a song back then called Bad. And it was really cool that anything that was good, anything that was fun, anything that you liked, you'd be like, that's bad, that's bad. And so my sisters and I would walk around and everything was bad. We'd be like, oh, that's so bad, that's so bad. And it would drive my parents crazy because they'd say, if you like something, say it's good. If you don't like something, then say it's bad. And in our minds, we would just kind of shake our heads and say, parents don't understand. And this is the process, recognizing that we will not always be privy to the conversations of our teens and our children. We won't always be allowed entrance into that secret realm. But we do have to understand it. And we do have to understand the avenues that we can follow and pursue to connect with our children. And it's not always by using the same words. Because I know I embarrass my teenagers all the time when I'm speaking to their friends and I'm like, oh, that's so on fleek. Or like, yeah, that's extra. And they're like, mom, don't. Like, just don't. So it's not about us adopting their language and utilizing it. It's about us listening. It's about being able to really hear our children when they speak to us. And to hear them not just with our ears, but to show them that we are interested in what they have to say. To connect with them with our eyes. To drop our devices, to put down the phone. And to really listen to them. To be present. To have them see that we are interested in their lives. We want to know what's going on. We want to have that connection with them. Because that's the foundation.